are getting ready to start our next renovation project. It is a bungalow. We are addressing one side of the house. We're going to address the master bath, the master closet, the main bathroom, and then we're going to create a new space for our clients. So come along and take a peek and see what we're up to. So we always start with our clients' as-is plan, and I'm going to be honest right now, this isn't exactly accurate because we are only going to be looking at this side of the house. The only thing we're doing in here is we're doing a lot of additional pot lights, some electrical on the exterior walls. We are getting rid of a fireplace that's here, but I can explain that a little later on. So I didn't bother to do the full house measurement because nothing is happening in here. In fact, I didn't actually do the actual measurement of the master bedroom either because that we're really not touching that either, other than updating the electrical. Where the magic is going to happen is in this walk-in closet, this master bathroom, this main bath, and part of this office. So we always like to talk about what are the pain points and what's not working, and there's a couple of things that are not working for our clients. Number one, when you open this door to the master bathroom, it hits this shower. It is really jammed up in here, and really for the person to use this sink, either the door has to be open, and right now it actually doesn't open fully all the way, or it has to be closed. This is really tight in here. It's a drop-in bathtub, but there's not a lot of ton of space. Another pain point is this current walk-in closet, where my clients do have a significant number of clothes, and this is vaulted, so it goes from 8 feet up to 10 feet here. And I think it's actually a little bit taller than that, to be honest. But it's not set up conducively for them. In this main bathroom, this is where they actually take a bath. And they are, both the Mr. and the Mrs. love their baths. So there's a standard bathtub right now, a standard toilet, a standard vanity. We're going to refresh this in a really nice way for them. And then currently this is used as an office, and this is a closet right now for them. And this is a front door. So again, we're not touching this part, but we are going to do some significant changes in this area here. So let's take a look and see what kind of magic we're going to do. So there's a couple of significant things we're going to do with the master ensuite walk-in closet. We are actually going to close off the existing door and make that a wall. And then we're going to have the entrance to the master closet, the walk-in closet, through the master bath. The swing is horrendous in here. There just isn't enough room. So we are going to use barn door hardware to create a sliding door that comes across here, and we don't have to worry about the swing anymore. A couple things in this bathroom is we're going to take the bathtub out. It's just way too crowded in here for a really nice bathtub. So we're going to take the existing bathtub and we're going to convert it to a shower. I will talk to you about why this is placed here when you see the three-dimensional. We actually have the opportunity to scoot this toilet down a little bit in this direction, so we are going to do that as much as we can. And then in this little half wall, this is a little stub wall, we're going to create a niche area in here so that things like toilet paper and feminine hygiene, those kind of things, can get tucked away out of sight, out of mind. What we are doing is significantly increasing the walk-in closet. My clients are hangers. They don't want drawers, they don't want a cabinet that has shelves in it other than one. And this cabinet here does have shelves. They're going to be adjustable shelves, and this is actually going to be more for bathroom things than closet things. So we're going to utilize this to have a double hang, double hang, double hang. And then this is a little bit of a narrower cabinet, but it's all for shoes, purses, boots. You should see what they've got. They've got a lot of stuff. So we're going to really utilize the height. This vaults up here, so it's really nice. It's got nice height to it. So this is a significant change. So we're going from three doors down to two. When we come in here to the main bath, we're getting rid of that standard one sink, one drawer vanity, and we're putting in a really fun, it ended up being a wood stained vanity instead of what I have on the in the 3D rendering, but that's okay. We're going to have a nice new toilet, and then we are installing a 36 inch wide bathtub. Now we're very fortunate in this house that we have the capability to scoot this toilet in this direction to allow us to have a wide 36 inch tub. So it's going to be really nice. A standard tub is 30 inches wide. This is going to be 36. It's going to be beautiful. And then in the office, this is going to remain an office, but we are creating a laundry space here. So right now the laundry is downstairs in this bungalow. We are creating a main floor second laundry. So they'll have two laundry areas in this house. And when I said to my clients, I always name the projects. I'm trying to rack my brain, come up with something creative. I'm not saying it's the Mr. or the Mrs., but one of them said, you need to call this project No More Excuses. Because there is going to be no more excuses not to have clothes put away. There's going to be no more excuses to have stuff in the bathroom laying around because now there's going to be plenty of space. And there's no more excuses because laundry is going to be on the same floor so they can get the laundry done and then they can put it away in their beautiful closet. So let's take a few peeks of what it looks like in the three-dimensional. So I hope I don't make anyone sick. This is just kind of the dollhouse view. So this is the master bath. This is the master. We're using a luxury vinyl plank in this that looks like tile. It's super cool. We're going to use nice big 18 by 36 inch wall tile and then some stone on the floor. In the main bathroom, there's existing hardwood. So we're actually keeping that. There's a lot we're doing in this house. This is like phase one. So we're going to keep the floor. It's actually going to be torn out. We're going to do all the plumbing to get the plumbing in for the laundry room here, and then we'll reinstall it. And then of course, we're going to have the laundry tucked in this closet here. We'll take the doors off and there'll be a shelf. So let's just take a little closer peek at things. So here is from the master master vanity, and this is looking into the closet. So once again, we've got there's lots of double hang. This is that half wall, and on this other side, there's that little niche in there for toilet paper and things. We're going to tile this whole entire wall. But if you notice, this is still a little bit crammed. It's not like the largest shower you've ever seen. It's not very wide. So we have a sliding door allocated, but we're putting the valve here so you don't have to walk in. Normally it's together on this wall, but we're not doing that. We're going to have the valve here. They can turn on the shower without having to walk in. They can reach in, feel if it's the right temperature, and then they can hop in. So that's a couple of significant things we're doing in this master bath. This is the view from inside the shower out. So we're not sure right now if there's going to be one shelf or two. We'll determine that on site. This is the open shelving unit where my clients most likely are going to keep their bathroom things, and it might end up being a mixture of bathroom and clothing things. Who knows? In the main bathroom, we've got a really fun vanity. Like I said, in our original renderings, we thought we would be doing a blue of some sort, a really fun blue. But my clients found a really nice wood stain vanity, so we're going with that. And the same tile in the shower is going to be used here. But like I said, this is a 36 inch wide, super, super wide and nice and relaxing. It's got a really good angle. And then in the laundry room, we're just putting a washer and dryer. They're already on site. They're a little smaller set from Bosch, super nice laundry. We're going to just do a countertop and then a spot to hang, whether it's to dry things or hang things when they come right out of the dryer. So now you can see that's a project that we're going to start on Monday. We are calling it No Excuses. That's what our clients want to call it. So hey, we're going to call it the No Excuses Project. So I look forward to updating you. We'll do some Facebook Lives and some Instagram Lives and probably another Instagram TV episode. So I hope you stay tuned and enjoy us on this journey with our clients.